Okay, so I'm here at the Teachers Research Conference in Buenos Aires, and here with me is teacher Viviana, and she has some wonderful strategies for reading comprehension. I would like her to talk about her poster.
Thank you. Well, I've been a teacher for 30 years now, and as I told you, I mean, I was very frustrated with this experience of teaching students or giving students lots of reading opportunities with the same outcome. They do a lot of reading and they understand very little. So I set out to study the theory behind reading comprehension, and I realized that there are many things we can do and many things we can learn and teach our students to tackle the text in different levels. We teachers of language are, I mean, we tend to overuse words, analyze words. Or sometimes we even take the text as the source of examples for certain linguistic patterns. But the text is much more than words and sentences and paragraphs. So I said, well, how could I design a very practical didactic tool for teachers and students to remember about these strategies? And that's how my gloves were born.
So we have 10 strategies.
10 strategies that tackle the text in its 3 constituents levels: the syntactic level, the semantic level, and the pragmatic. So first is scrutinize the paratext, all that is around the text: titles, pictures, graphs, epigraphs, drawings. Tie up enunciation hints: who wrote this? To whom? Where? Why? When? Relate the text to what you know about the text content and the text type, that is the theory of reader schemata. We don't read the same any all kinds of texts. So what is this text type? Analyze the words we don't know. We teachers of English love this, but we overuse this. Throw light on sentence structure. Explore how the text is woven together. You know, text comes from the Latin word textus, which means fabric. A text is a combined, it's a kind of fabric, right? So we have to explore how the text is woven together. Cohesion and coherence. Greek reference to their references, and all this has to do with pronouns, cataphoric, endophoric, and exophoric reference. Identify main ideas, and here's where we teach our students paragraph division, and we tell them that each paragraph contains a different idea, so they have to sort of pinpoint the different ideas in the text. And finally, explore the author's hidden intentions in writing this. We always write with a purpose in mind. So what is this author trying to do? What is the writer trying to do? Is he trying to convince me, to persuade me, to entertain me, to inform me? What is the hidden intention behind this? And finally, sense your own feelings about the text. Because we know in contemporary approaches to reading that the reader completes the meaning of the text. So what is your reaction? How do you feel? So, this way we tackle all levels of text analysis and comprehension.
And you were saying that you trained teachers, and there was a teacher who said, who told you that you were wasting your time. Can you elaborate on that?
Yeah, well that was...
How many big teachers like fall in love with reading?
Well, I think that first of all, we have to read in a different way. Many times we say, read it again, and I think that's not enough. Reading again is not enough. It's reading differently that really makes a difference. So once you feel and you learn that there are different things you can do to understand the text different and to untangle these difficult points in the text, you become enjoying it, because reading is an adventure that everybody, I mean, he who reads lives 1,000 lives within a lifespan. So many times I say we are very heavy-handed on teachers, and we say we don't teach reading strategies, but we don't teach because we don't know. So how can we teach something we don't know? So, but I studied, I designed this, and I train teachers so that they can learn them to teach them.
Wonderful. Thank you very much.
Thank you.